Part 2. Crimson Flower. Pegasus Moon. Tempest of Swords and Shields. With Daedru under Imperial control, the Lester Alliance ceases to exist, and its remaining lords ally themselves with the Empire. The Black Eagle Strike Force, having now conquered all of Eastern Fodlan, confidently moves to invade the kingdom.
And that concludes Count Burgles' report. Just as Claude said, the old alliance has willingly fallen under Imperial rule. However, knowing him, there is no telling what manner of poison could be waiting within. We must be careful not to expose any weakness.
Of course, though it seems we can now attack the kingdom without issue.
True. However, you should know that Lord Arendelle has entered Daedru. It would seem he has already started collecting the relics of the old alliance.
Let him do as he pleases for now. It's not yet the time to chide him.
Understood. As for the kingdom, as we theorized, it is not entirely united. If we defeat the royal family of House Blathed, and a handful of other notable houses, it should fall under our control quite readily. Those we must target include the houses Fraldarius, Galatea, Gautier, and Karen. We have allies who are close to some of those lords. Perhaps that can be used to our advantage. Persuasion by tears or threats. Perhaps one would consent to act as a hostage. We must make good use of the tools given to us.
What about House Roe in Arianrode, the fortress city? Will they not side with us?
The head of House Fraldarius, Lord Rodrigue, has entered the city. It is possible that he has seized it.
I see. Then it might prove too difficult to strike Ferdiad right away.
Either way, when preparations are complete, we can begin our deployment into the kingdom.
That part of the plan remains unchanged. Professor, is something wrong? Yes, I don't imagine that you have much interest in a running list of noble names. But it matters not. The nobility and the weight of all those names will be gone once the war is over. This month, we must again put all of our effort into preparing for battle. I'm counting on you, my teacher. Professor, you didn't hear anything just now, did you? Cute! Huh. Well, be that as it may, it is not your concern. It was nothing. You seem to be trying your hardest to infuriate me. Don't you dare say that again! It's just... well... there was a rat. I don't enjoy the company of rats. I believe I've told you about this before, about when I was held captive beneath the palace. There were a lot of rats there. To this day, I just... What? Oh, Professor, leave here at once. I recall now that Hubert needs to speak with me. I must change my clothes. Now, whatever you do, don't look this way. Then forget what you saw. That's an order.
Thank you.
There. We must rethink the supply route now that the battle lines have moved. This one will be Hubert, and Count Burgley's will oversee this force here. Ah, Professor. Is something wrong? Sorry, I thought I had a bit more time before the council meeting. True, though ideally I'd like to hand off anything I can to my subordinates. While we're on the front lines, I can't help but worry about every little thing. Now, let's see.
Pardon, Your Majesty. An urgent matter.
What's happened?
There is an army from Almira at Fodlan's throat. Reports indicate it is of appreciable size. A steep mountain range runs along the border between Fodland and Almira. Mountain range is called Fodlan's Throat. The sturdy fortress built within those mountains is called Fodlan's Locket. It occupies the sole path through. The Church and the Alliance nobles built the Locket to safeguard against Almiran invasion.
Normally, House Goneril watches over the fortress. In times of trouble, the lords join together to protect it. But I assume it would be too difficult to defend against this incursion with only the troops of Goneril.
The situation has been precarious for House Goneril since Holst fell ill. The heir to House Goneril, renowned for his bravery, he is Hilda's elder brother.
Holst is a formidable commander. It's only logical that House Goneril would struggle in his absence. The Alliance is shattered. They can't request soldiers from the surrounding lords. And the Imperial troops stationed there can't be relocated so easily. The best course of action is for us to go out there and deal with this ourselves. It's critical for us to protect that location. This is our chance to prove that we won't allow it to fall.
Yes. It is to the benefit of our future governance not to abandon it. It seems this must be done. Will you assist us?
We'll depart after you finish making preparations. Move swiftly. We must move before the Almiran army crosses the throat. It seems we made it in time. Let's help the soldiers of House Goneril withdraw. The Black Eagle Strike Force will protect Fodlan's Locket.
Support! We're saved!
Reinforcements? And that flag belongs to the Imperial Army! Ha! A fine enemy indeed! Break through the locket and make a name for yourself. No need to be shy. Strike all at once.
We fight to protect Fodlan. If the defensive line is broken, we fail. Our enemies are many, but we can use the terrain to our advantage and stop them where they stand.
My strategy.
For the Empire.
I'll cut a bloody path. I'm awake.
More fighting. Ready when you are. I do this for all of us.
Hardly worth the effort.
the pace. There's no turning back now. No.
I think I'd let you go. I think.
One step closer to victory. all the... Very impressive. Well done. Good form.
Grand ambitions.
Prepare yourself. My duty is your job. I aim for greatness. Won't be in vain. All is going to plan. Winning is what matters.
Your sword is fit to cleave a mountain in two. Care to try it out against the undefeated Nadir? So this is how far I go. Unbelievable. What a scary moment.
There's still...
I dare! Impossible! Everyone withdraw! Run!
No matter how many times you attack, we will never allow you to capture the throat. The Almiran troops are difficult opponents. For now, I would much rather focus on Fodlan's internal territories. I hope they... The Almiran army retreated. Their casualties were numerous. As I understand it, they won't be attempting another invasion anytime soon. Still, we must prepare the local troops before their enemy returns. Indeed. But if possible, I would like to foster amicable relations with them. Unlike Fodlan, Almira is not a land ruled by blind fealty to the goddess. I believe we need only to communicate openly with them and respect the differences between our cultures. If we do that, we should be able to have a meaningful dialogue with them, one more promising than what we can expect from followers of the goddess. Ah, Hubert, what did Duke Goneril say?
He expresses his sincere gratitude to Lady Edelgard. In addition, he would like to leave the protection of the throat to Imperial troops from now on.
Is that so? How reasonable of him. By the way, what was it that ailed Holst?
I did not hear all the details, but apparently he ate some bad mushrooms. It is said he is now emaciated and pale, and his skin exudes a mysterious vapor.
Huh. I can't help but imagine what that must look like. But it's probably better not to think about it.
Agreed. Do not worry yourself with such thoughts.
There's only one option, then. I must pay a visit on my own and see this ailment with my own eyes. Actually, on second thought, I'd better not. As Emperor, I can't risk it.
Professor, you're here. No. But while you are here, you may as well listen. I am sure you recall hearing about Kranya Solon and Lord Arendelle. I'm investigating their true identities. I want to know their origins, their numbers, their base of operations, their plans. I want to know where they acquired their dark powers, how they disguise themselves. Many intriguing mysteries surround these people. Wouldn't you agree? I have a name for them. Those who slither in the dark.
Lord Hubert, pardon me, but Lord Arendelle is at the monastery. He says he wants to discuss something with you and is waiting in the reception hall.
Speaking of, Professor, would you come along?
Hubert, I have something I must request of you.
Request? That is an unusual word choice. A request, by definition, can be refused. But if you have orders, Regent, I will follow them.
Such a reaction before you even hear me out. Very well. One of my subordinates was conducting experiments in the sealed forest. The demonic beast he was using ran wild and has created something of a situation. Take care of it.
Experiments, you say? Very well. I will set out at once. Professor, will you assist? you for your support. It is a great help. Like this forest became infested with demonic beasts while we weren't looking. I suppose we've not that I'm concerned for any of these people. But since there may be a reward in it for us, we may as well do what we can to rescue them. Now then, let's split up and move in to assist. It may be worth focusing your attention on those being targeted by multiple demonic beasts.
To be done.
Think carefully.
Thank you.
appreciate it.
Hard work is a friend to count on.
Our chance. This is our chance.
No turning back now. Let's keep up the pace.
Strength is all for a mercenary.
What a disgrace to be saved by those fools. Enough. These certainly proved useful. Go ahead and take them.
Your tools, I gather. Yes, I suppose we will take them off your hands, since you asked so nicely.
I'm surprised at you, Hubert, saving all of my poor subordinates. It seems gratitude is in order. Let us meet again soon.
Good riddance. What a nuisance that man is. He and his ilk must be aware of my investigation. No doubt this was all an attempt to make us believe we are powerless against them. It has only achieved the opposite effect. They are looking down on us. They think we cannot touch them, but the closer we get to them, the less true that becomes. Just look at this weaponry we received as a token of their appreciation. It would be impossible for us to manufacture such a piece with our current tools and knowledge. It is not as powerful as a relic, but it is nearly so. We will keep them close for now, while we still need their strength to rule Fodlan. Once Fodlan is united, however, the focus of this war will shift. Rather than swords clashing on the battlefield, it will be knives cutting in the darkness. Lady Edelgard's war will be over, and House Vestra's will begin. We who rule the shadows will eradicate those who slither in the dark. When that time comes, Professor, you will be quite useful to us. Age is but a number.
There's something I'd like...
You're certainly not going easy on me. You fight like a mercenary.
Each milestone informs
the battle. Now is the time.